Hello friends, welcome back to the next session on general insurance. Now let's begin our learning. In this particular session, we'll be understanding and dealing with the concepts of practical problems in insurance industry, that is the general insurance as well as the reinsurance. The learning objectives of these particular sessions are, we'll be describing the limitations in the reinsurance industry and the practical problems that have been associated with the reinsurance industry. Now let's look at the limitations of reinsurance industry in detail. Now a business has to think about good and bad decision, profitability and loss, cost saving and increased or decreased rating. So here in this case, the limitations for a reinsurance industry is always the reinsurance company has to see whether the deal or whether the transaction that you are going to enter into or the policy that will be undertaken will be profitable or not profitable. Whether the situation will be favorable or unfavorable, whether the condition will be good or bad, whether the decision that will be taken will be in a positive way or will be in a negative way impacting the company. So it acts as or it limits the boundaries of a certain company and its expansion, because depending on the policies, depending on the terms and conditions, depending on the change in the market conditions, the decision of getting or finalizing a reinsurance contract is being undertaken. Profitability and loss. In terms of the profitability and loss, there is always a set or decided percentage between the insured person, the insurance company and the reinsurance company. Now, in case there is a conflict for the profitability and loss percentage, if there is a conflict in respect to the computation of the loss that has been done by the insurance company or the reinsurance company, there comes a limitation as to what justification needs to be provided and what amount of compensation needs to be given. So, estimation of profitability and loss is always uncertain, it is always unfavorable and not satisfying to the respective parties. So here in this case, it comes a certain limitation about whether the reinsurance contract is profitable or the reinsurance contract is not profitable. The next concern we have is cost saving measures and expenditures. There are various measures that have been undertaken by an individual for saving of cost. This particular cost is always associated in terms of benefiting the client, benefiting the insured person and benefiting the company itself. So, saving a single penny in terms of an expenditure is almost of utmost importance, and accordingly, we have to see that how the cost is being saved by the insurance company as well as the reinsurance company. And lastly, increasing or decreased rating. At every stage, depending on the computation of loss, depending on the finalization of a claim, depending on settlement of disputes, the rating of the company either increases, that is, goes up, or the rating of the company decreases, that is, goes down. So there is a certain limitation on the satisfactory level of the consumers or the insured person. If the insured person is not satisfied with the claim or the compensation, then accordingly the business may get hampered, and accordingly the businessman has to think of whether the rating is either increasing or decreasing. Now let's move towards the practical problems that have been associated in the reinsurance industry. The first practical problem that the reinsurance company or the contract has to suffer is with respect to the price regulation. Always, there is a reduction of cost in terms of each and every individual person. The cost may be incurred or it may be cutted in or it may be reduced down in terms of the remuneration, in terms of the premium, in terms of the transaction level, in terms of the payment terms and conditions and so on. And hence, the price regulation acts as a mediator or acts as a controlling factor with respect to a problem that can be associated with respect to the insurance or the reinsurance industry. The next problem that can be associated with respect to the reinsurance is case-by-case differentiation. Always, every case is different from one another. That is, either the policies of either life insurance, health insurance, general insurance, motor insurance, vehicle insurance, and so on. So every individual type of insurance is different and every person's policy is different. The policy or the terms and conditions in the policy of person A may be different. Policy in the terms and conditions of the person B, person C, X, Y, Z, and so on, n number of people are different. So Always, the reinsurance company contractor has to see that the case-to-case differentiation always needed to be undertaken, and accordingly, the benefit or the utmost profit must be provided, and the compensation that has been finalized should be profitable to the insurance company as well as to the reinsurance company, and both the parties must be utmost satisfaction level to the ultimate insured person. Another problem that can be associated with the reinsurance is negotiation. The terms of negotiation, that is the talks of negotiation, may be either on or off, that is, it may either commence or it may either discommence, that is, it may be closed down. The terms of negotiation can be either related with the agreement, that is, the terms and conditions and the validity of the contract, the skill, expertise, and knowledge that has been required of a salesman or a particular broker or the insurance company. The communication that is needed to be done between the parties who are involved into the contract, that is the communication between the insured person and the insurance company and the ultimately reinsurance company, the tactics or the game plans that has to be played with respect to the computation and the settlement of losses, the validity and terms and conditions of the contract according to the renewal and policy duration of the contract, collaboration between the insurance company, the brokers, the agent, the sub-commission agents, the third-party administrators, the insurance surveyor and loss assessors, and so on. So these are the various parties or collaborators who are involved in the computation of the insurance contract. And lastly, what is the goal? Whether the goal is for profit making, loss making, or it is for just creating the consumers. So the goal should be ultimate satisfaction of the consumers and settling the disputes or settling the claims in the specified time period. Another problem that has been associated with the risk insurance is with respect to the flexibility in terms and conditions of the contract. So, according to the laws, according to the provisions, according to the regulatory authorities' guidelines that have been provided, it must be seen that the terms and conditions of the contract, either by the insured person, by the insurance company, or the reinsurance company, everything has been fulfilled on time, and accordingly, a proper contract terms and conditions have been complied by all the parties who are been associated in that particular contract. The another problem that has been associated with the reinsurance company is excess of loss of reinsurance. So, as per the risk of loss, it may be either at an increasing stage or it may be either at an decreasing stage. So, here in this case, let's take an example. The price of a particular product. For a particular single product, the price may either be decreased or it may be counted in terms of a certain quantity, that is 250 by 250, wherein 250 components for 250 components, one component to one component, three component to two components, five components to five components, or multiple components. So in this case-to-case differentiation is into existence, and a contract may be applied or it may be implemented for a single policy or it may be implemented for a different policy. An individual having a single contract or a single policy, he may deal with only one insurance provider. But an insurance company having several number of policies may refer to either several reinsurance companies or only one insurance company. So in this way, a practical problem can be seen with respect to the excess of loss of policy to policy. That is, it is always differing from person to person, policy to policy, and category to category of health insurance or the life insurance or the general insurance. Another problem that has been associated with respect to reinsurance is the client and broker negotiation. There is always a negotiation round that has been conducted between the client and between the broker who acts as a middleman. So, if the terms and conditions are needed to be altered, if they are needed to be modified, there comes a problem or a practical problem with respect to whether the conditions are needed to be accepted, what modifications have been done, and the approval from the respective authorities. Another problem that has been associated is with respect to the layer trap, that is, the last minute changes. At a certain stages, it has been observed that either the client, that is the insured person, or the insurance company, or the reinsurance company, make the changes or modifications in the terms and conditions of the contract on the last minute. So there comes a certain problem about acceptability and finalizing of a certain claim, or finalizing or concluding of a certain contract. There are different expectations from either the brokers, clients, middlemen, insurance surveyor, middlemen, the parties who are involved in the reinsurance contract. So, a certain intermediary who is acting a link between the insured person, the insurance company and the reinsurance company at that particular stage, the conflict may arise, and accordingly, their expectations differ from person to person and case to case. Giving back or sharing. So always here in this case, there should be a sharing, that is give and take relationship between the parties. That is, whatever profit that has been generated, it must be shared between the insurance company and the reinsurance company, and between the members, that is the brokers, sub-brokers, agents, contractors, and so on. So in this way, supply exchange is utmost required. Now let's summarize what we have learned in this particular session. In this particular session, we have looked out the various limitations that have been associated with the reinsurance contract. In the next concern, we have also dealt with the several practical problems that have been associated with reinsurance, and the various examples or the diversified examples with respect to the practical problems was also being undertaken. I hope you must have enjoyed the learning. We'll stay connected. Thank you.